then he, maybe he... Oh! What is that word?
What the hell?
I cannot figure this out. What were you doing back in 1995?
I can't. It's not working. I've never seen that before.
Penny! They don't make it easy. Hello and welcome to Retro 70s Kid, where tonight, finally, I am unboxing and reviewing the Waterworld 1995 Kenner Trimaran and action figures. The Kevin Costner one, the Mariner, and the Nord figure. You would have seen me buy this about 8 weeks ago. We did a show when I went to some vintage toy shops in the Carrara markets on the Gold Coast, and I bought this. And I said to the owner who sold it to me, I said, I'll buy this if you have some figures to go with it. Which he said, oh yes, I have some figures. I have all the figures and the other craft. If you see on the back here, there are all these other figures and the two jet skis. And he promised he had a box of this stuff, and he had it at home in a shed, which he had to go through. And that was 8 weeks ago, and he's got my phone number and email, and I've been back about four or five times, and he still doesn't have it, and I'm kind of thinking he was just trying to tell me a story so he could sell it. So I went online and I got these, which, by the way, small story, there are some good people out there still. I had it stuff up with Australia Post. It wasn't delivered to my address, it went straight to the depot. They didn't give me any information that they had my stuff. Any notification, and it was then sent back to the seller. Now the seller, Brandon and Son, hi Brandon, when I messaged him and told him what had happened, I said, look, I'm happy to pay for the cost of the repostage. And he texted me back and said, look, I'm really happy to just pay for the post and send it back to you. So that was really nice. He went above and beyond the call of duty. So checking his shop out, Brandon and Son on eBay, they've got a perfect score. So I highly recommend them. So thank you, Brandon, for that. Anyway, back to it. 1995 Trimaran. Let's go back to 1995. Look at this box. Look at the artwork. Sorry, Penny's in the way. Now, we might be showing you a clip of the Trimaran from the movie, because I love Waterworld. I think it's a great movie. I'm going to turn it over. It's Mad Max on the Water, which I think is awesome. And it was panned at the time, but it's now a classic, and I think it actually does have a cult following. And earlier this year, they released a 25th anniversary extended cut of the movie, which I think is far better than the original. I highly recommend it if you get the chance.
Oh,
So, alrighty then. Slice it open. What were you doing back in 1995? I had a lounge room full of inflatable furniture. Ouch. Which was, just sidebar. I've got, this is 25 years old. I had two of these tulips. I had a black and white zebra print two-seater lounge, two of these purple single lounges and footstools and a few other things. It was very, very cool, but anyway. A lot of this will probably be on fast forward. Actually, the box is actually in quite good condition. There's scuff marks, but it's in here really out of the way. Thank you. Go out on full or not. I don't even know if I'm doing this the right way, you know, but it won't come out.
I can't. It's not working.
Well, I don't want to wreck the box. Wait a minute. Will that come out now? Okay. All right. It's out. Now, let's see what we've got. Ooh. Nice. This is going to be huge. Well, the mast alone is apparently 21 inches. So bits and pieces. That's the mast. That's the main metal section. Oh, this is good. There we go, they're all the pieces. Now, instructions. Okay. All right, I think we're going to put it together and we'll come back to you.
1 eternity later.
And we're back. Wow, what a job that was. But look at this. Look at it. It is amazing. It took about, how long did it take us? About half an hour to put together. It was pretty straightforward. However, this netting was a very long, slow, tedious process. It had to be pushed in. If producer can get a close-up, you can't really see, but tiny little things on the side. He had to try and stretch one of those little holes of the netting over it. And it was almost impossible. I couldn't do any of it. Producer had to do it all. So thank you, producer, for helping me with all this. But it's so worth it. Look at this. So you've got the netting, you've got the mast, you've got the what are these called? The harpoon launchers. I'll just launch this, it'll come towards you. I won't do the other one. And there's one at the front. And it's got a wheel on the bottom so it can effortlessly roll. I don't have a blue tablecloth. I wish I had a blue tablecloth, but I don't have one to simulate water. And then you've also got, this is his steering control at the back. He's got the winch. So it's when it's in like the cruise mode, which is, take that off, which is these, what are these called? These propeller things here. When you hit that and it can, the wind powers it and it just slowly goes around, and he can dredge the bottom of the ocean floor, which is where he gets his soil and his salvage from. And then the other thing it does, oh no, these come off really easily. Now I'll push this back down again and it locks into place. And manually, We'll probably show you a clip of this. You raise that. You open up these doors. And out comes the sail. Clip it to the top. Look at that. Yeah, that's Jurassic Park thing. Oh, dear. And this... Oh, I've got to show you the things before I can do this. So that's that beautiful example of Waterworld. Now we've got the figures. Let's open the Mariner, the Kevin Costner figure. We've shown you the back of it. So we've got the figure and his mutant moray eel and his power bow. So we'll quickly... I don't want to really wreck the packaging too much. Nice packaging too, I really like the packaging. So here's Kevin, or Mariner. He kind of looks like, look at the detail in his costume. Very similar to the movie. He looks like a kind of a remolded figure of the Robin Hood Prince of Thieves movie that I think he did before this. And it's almost got a sheen to it. He's really nice. And his basic articulation, that's all right. This is the moray eel, translucent. Because in Waterworld, they've got a lot of mutant sea creatures like the whale fin, which is like a cross between a giant whale, shark, and a dolphin with sideways opening jaws, if you remember that scene in the movie. If this movie had been a hit at the time, if they went to this much trouble with the first release, the second release, imagine what we could have had. We could have had the whale fin in actual size. We could have had the atoll. We could have had, what else was there? The Exxon Valdez oil carrier, that the Deacon, the bad guy, the bad villain with the patch had. We could have had some amazing things, but we never got there. So let's do this. That's still quite strong after 25 years. And the projectiles. They're actually all different. The three of those are... No, two of them are the same, one's different. That's cool. So how does this work? I think that's a separate gun. Of... No. Is it a harpoon? How does he hold that? Oh, okay, he kind of holds that. Not very straight. And this one... Let me have a look at the back. No, that way. No. It is that way. I cannot figure this out. Left hand is holding this. It's the other. But then how's he supposed to? I don't know. I have no idea. This obviously has to go in there. And then he maybe he... Oh! Oh, that kind of worked. Okay, so you pull it in here. It's too awkward for him to hold it. But... oh, it's a little underwhelming, but that other one went further. Anyway, doesn't matter. We've got Kevin. And he can stand... where are his holes? Where are they? He can stand here. He fits those controls beautifully. And there are all these other spots for other action figures. I'd like to get the, what's that lady and the little girl with the tattoo on her back? They're a must for this. You have to have those for this figure. But this guy is the sidekick of the deacon, of the villain. And he's called Nord because of his Nordic features. And he comes with a mutant crab. So see, with the villains, you really need the vehicles to go with the villains. Otherwise, what are you going to do with a villain on the ocean without any vehicles? Unless he's having a fight with the mariner on the boat. Oh, well, I've got a figure. Let's see how this works. Now, if you've seen the movie, he goes flying sort of over the ship with... so you attach, put his hand through here. He actually hangs onto that. He'd be standing here and, oh, I need to get over to the other side. Let me put it in a bit better. I can't see, that light's in the way. All right, here he goes. Okay, he's on this side, and he wants to go over to the other side. No, and then he goes up the mast. And from this side, he can go up the mast. Well, let's fly mount him around it. Oh, that's one way of doing it. Oh, that's fun. Anyway. The Nord. Let's have a look at Nord. There we go. He's got great detail. And the texture as well. Lots of texture. Okay, so that's Nord, and here's his mutant crab, in a lovely kind of red, almost translucent red with three claws and legs. He's quite evil looking. Actually, these sea creatures, you don't see them in the movie, but you do see them in the comic book. There was an amazing comic book released, which I did have the whole series and I've sold it on since. Called Children of Leviathan, and I highly recommend it. It spans the universe, and all these little creatures that they show here make an appearance in the comic, and apparently also in a couple of the video games that were released at the time. All these creatures made an appearance. So that's interesting. Now with Nord, we've got his... what is it? Some sort of a blaster? Firing bazooka bomber. It sounds like an aircraft. Okay. Thank you. Right. On his right shoulder. See, simple. I knew that. Hi, puss. There we go. Now, I'm guessing we press. Yeah, that's pretty good. Oh, Penny. Penny! Almost gotcha. And then this is... just like another crossbow thing. I don't know how that... they don't make it easy. That doesn't even fire. But it goes on something. Oh, who cares? Anyway. So there's Nord. Can you get out of the way? We'll pretend Nord's a good guy. He could be up the front. There we go. So there we go. That's the right theme.
Yep.
The beautiful 1995 Kenner Waterworld Trimaran. Penny!
She just wants to be in the shot.
Get out of the way. Really, people want to see this. They want to see you. There we go. Isn't that beautiful?
Wow.
An awesome 90s toy. Now, if and when I get those other vehicles that I was promised from the seller, I will do a separate show on those. So that's it. My wonderful Waterworld unboxing. Thank you for joining me. Don't forget to like and subscribe. Thank you, Brandon and Dad, again. And join me next time for something different. I think it might be Vintage Action Jackson. Thank you and good night. You? What are you doing?
No, I've got a question for you guys.
Yeah.
Do you have a place to store it?
No, I have nowhere to put it. And it was so hard to put together, I don't want to take it apart again.
No, you don't.
So it might just be sitting right in the middle of my coffee table. I don't know where I'm going to put it. I just don't know. I'm at that stage. I need to, yes. But still working.
Well, it's really nice.
Mm.